Welcome, everyone. Normally at this point I would say welcome back, but there's been some changes. I am back here at 44 North, filming the best I can because I got here after dark. So I got my headlamp over there, fire that I should have thrown another log on right in front of me, but hopefully you can see me. If not, you can hear me. So to open this video up, I'm sure you've noticed that this is the first episode of Average Jay's Camping. After 50 episodes of Scamping with Jay, I have decided to rebrand, and I thought you guys needed a bit of an explanation on what the rebranding was all about. And in a nutshell, Scamping, I think, was confusing, possibly off-putting, because not everybody's into ska music, even if they got the ska reference. I mean, the checkerboard was there in the logo. And just, you know, a few things. I'm trying to do this off the top of my head here, but, you know, obviously if you've been following me the whole time, it started off with my scooter and a trailer, Scamping, scooter camping. After a few trips, I realized that that just wasn't a feasible idea with the scooter and trailer that I have. I'd have to find camping in Milwaukee County and Milwaukee County alone, so I'm not riding for 8 hours, excuse me, to a location. Because for me to come from my house in Milwaukee to here in Tigerton up here at 44 North, it would be about an 8 hour ride. And that's a long time to be on a little 49cc scooter. So that didn't work. So I decided to opt for my love of ska music, specifically third wave ska. Change the C to a K, Scamping with Jay continues. I wanted to do kind of a music incorporation to that, but I'm just a smaller channel, one guy. I don't understand copyright laws and royalty-free music and all that mumbo-jumbo. So I didn't want to start putting music on this channel and start having it flagged for copyright and strike this and strike that. And you know, I just didn't want to do that. I see a lot of YouTube videos where they've gone back and had to re-edit it because they got a strike, and I spend enough time editing as it is, so that didn't work out. Another couple reasons is I knew of the Scamp trailer, the SCAMP. I knew of that one. If it's a trailer, I still consider it glamping, but apparently that little group calls it scamping. I thought I was out of that wormhole when I changed it to a K. Then my nephew Max, who will be getting here in about an hour, he found a picture of a Scamp trailer with a K, which I'm sure is just some knockoff that was trying to earn money on the other Scamp's name. So I just felt it was best to go forward with a complete rebrand. And what better time to do it than on video 51. So I had 50 videos as Scamping with Jay. Here's video 51, video 1 of Average Jay's Camping. The direction I'm going to go with this channel now, because I kind of got sidetracked and I really haven't had a solid how I'm going to do things. The reason for Average Jay's is it's a play on Average Joe. And what I want to show is any average Joe can come out into the woods, have a good time. You don't need a travel trailer. You don't need expensive equipment. You don't need a $300 tent. You don't need a $200 sleeping bag. You just don't. Are those nicer? Sure. But you're paying for it, though. For what some people spend on a tent, I spend my entire summer camping on that budget. It's incredible. So that's where I want to go with this channel. I'm going to do, you know, cheap reviews, not cheap, but inexpensive, budget-friendly reviews. Some of it might be cheap garbage. Some of it may turn into that hand crank blower that I got off of Temu that I bought as a joke, and it's actually one of my more valuable camping tools at this point. So that's where we're going. It's dark out right now. It is time to crack open a nice cold Coors Banquet. So to finish off this segment of the video, I just want to say cheers. Thanks for watching.
All right, everyone. We're all set up here. It's Saturday afternoon. Tied one on pretty heavy last night, but fully recovered, fully ready to go for round two. Ding, ding. It's been a nice day. It got to the low 80s. I spent most of the day napping in my hammock. Max and Gina have been out and about running around because they're not really campers. They're adventurers. Camping means you sit here and do nothing. But as long as you're having a good time, that is what's important. So they can do their thing. I can do my thing. Best of both worlds. So anyway, I said I was going to start doing reviews and other things of that nature more often. So what I'd like to do is give a shout out to a local artist here and fan of the channel, Facebook friend of mine, by the name of Matt Haney. You can find his Facebook page called Homemade Goodies. I'll put the link here on the screen. I'll also put it down in the description. You can click on it there. But what he does, he makes horseshoe art. And I saw a picture of this and was like, man, I need one of those. Because I've always just used my cooler as an end table. And then you got to move everything to get another beer out of the cooler, then set everything back down. So I thought, man, that would be awesome. So, see two horseshoes at the top. That's the little pad to step on it and drive it into the ground. Want to say there's probably 12 inches of rebar in the ground right now, so it is super sturdy. Like, it's not moving anywhere. If you walk into it, it's going to hurt. Hence why I wanted mine in white, so at night I can see it. So I was going to look to see if there was a little basket or something I could put in here for my vape, but then I figured out that a big foamy non-collapsible koozie just sits right in there, and that worked out just fine. So yeah, definitely if you're looking for any type of yard art or a beer holder for your backyard or camping or any of that nature, go ahead and follow the link below to his page to get in contact with him, and you guys can work out the details yourself. I paid $20 for that. And like I said, it's sturdy, it's well built, it's painted, it's good to go. So I am just going to kick back and watch the MLW wiffle ball game of the week and wait for Max and Gina to get back here. We'll see you soon. Well, I went and did it again. I didn't film anything when Max and Gina were here, except for that short little video when they went on their adventure day. It's been a fun weekend. If you've been following on Facebook, we went and hung out at the river for a little while. We went into town. We went for a drive when it was raining out. Did a little sightseeing up to Anago and, you know, a couple other small towns that are up here. So I did go ahead and opt to stay until Monday. I did want to do a four-day weekend. But the weather wasn't looking like it was going to be very friendly as far as the heat goes. So Max and Gina have left. It's a little too warm for Abby. So totally understandable. Plus they wanted to beat the holiday traffic. So I opted to stay one more day. It is currently, I think, 93 degrees or something. Let me look it up here real quick. No, 91. Currently at 91 degrees. The saving grace, though, is the humidity is only 37%. So it's warm, but it's completely tolerable. But I'm going to try and get some videos made tonight. Kind of wrap up this weekend. And this is my lonesome alone night, you know, which isn't lonesome. I'm not going to drink tonight. I've a three-day bender is more than enough at my age. I don't need to be dragging it on to four. So tonight's just going to be chilling, watching videos on my phone, and hanging out. So right now I'm going to get in the car, turn the AC on. I'm going to head into Wittenberg and try Papa John's for the first time. Haven't had it. I've heard mixed things. Let's go check it out for myself. We'll see you a little later. Hey, we're still going here at 44 North, Sunday afternoon. It's about 4 p.m. or so. Temperature 97, feels like 98. Warmer than the last clip, but still really bearable. Like, I'm sweating and I'm warm, but it's nothing like that old Chorus Family Farm weekend where it was just 98 and muggy and feels like 110 or whatever that weekend was. That was intense. Well, it's camping, it's always intense. So, but yeah, so we're back. Had a little hiccup, of course, you know, when I'm camping with somebody else and we're off adventuring in their car and mine just sits here, going in and out of the tailgate, going in and out of the doors without starting the engine, and dead battery. So luckily Matt came to the rescue again, gave me a jump start, and we're back on track. So drove into Wittenberg, picked up some Taco John's, never had it, gonna try it, see what the fuss is about, or what the fuss isn't about, I guess, because like I said earlier, I've heard mixed reviews on it, so we'll give it a try myself. Still not going to drink tonight. Did stop at the BP gas station that we normally stop at here, and, well, pretty good sign, they're out of Coors Banquet, so I got, you know, just nature and chance telling me not to drink today, so not drinking, just sitting, just chilling. But yeah, we'll continue on with the night. Still undecided if I'm going to have a campfire tonight. You know, might walk the wagon down and pick up a load of firewood. But yeah, I'm not even really sure on that. It's a little hot to be thinking about fire right now, but it's going to be this hot for a couple hours, and then once the sun goes down, it's supposed to fall right back into the 70s, so it should be really nice sleeping weather tonight when I finally go to bed. I'm not going to pull a 4 a.m. all-nighter like I've done the last three nights. Going to try and get to bed 10, 11 tonight. Set my alarm for, you know, maybe 7, maybe 6:30, who knows. Try and get packed up here and on the road before all the normal Labor Day traffic kicks in tomorrow, because everybody's going to be going home tomorrow. But hopefully if I can get on the road early enough, I can just get home and get unpacked before it gets super hot tomorrow. But yeah, so I'm going to go ahead and eat lunch, and we'll check back in with you later. All right, guys, it is about 6 o'clock, I think. Nope, 6:04. And we are at -95 degrees, so the heat has broke. About 5 minutes before I started shooting this video, it was at 96, and just a few minutes before that it was at 97, so we are over that hot weather hump. It's all downhill from here. You can see shortly after the sun goes down, it is going to drop right back down into the 70s, so it's going to be a nice comfy sleep tonight, and once the sun goes down, it's going to be a bit more comfortable. Again, it's not horrible out here. The humidity is at 31% right now. So when it comes to Wisconsin temperature and Wisconsin heat, the humidity is going to be the biggest factor. I'm not going to get into a dry heat versus muggy heat because they're both hot. They are both hot. So that whole, you know, it's a dry heat thing in Arizona. Yeah, but it's still hot in Arizona. So it is what it is. But it's definitely nicer and more tolerable when it's not, you know, 80% humidity or 90% humidity. But, yeah, like I said, just a chill day, just sitting around and relaxing. No beers, ate Taco John's for lunch. Wasn't that great. Yeah, now I'm just going to kick back and probably find something to watch on Netflix. I was thinking of taking a nap, but it being, you know, 6 o'clock, I took a nap, I'm going to be up all night, and I really don't want to do that, so I'm going to
fight with myself to stay awake here for a few more hours, and who knows, if I'm still this exhausted 2 hours from now at 8 o'clock, I'll crawl up into the hammock and go to sleep early and get up even earlier. The sooner I get home, the better, because it's another hot one tomorrow, so I don't want to be unloading the car at home in 95 degree heat. That's not going to be fun or enjoyable for anybody. So, want to get out of here, you know, 7-ish at the latest, 7:30 maybe I should say at the latest. I'd like to be home by 10, 11 before it gets overly warm. So, yeah, stick around. I'll have a couple more segments here at least before we wrap up this weekend. But thanks for watching this far. We'll be back. All right, guys, here we are at the 10 minutes to 8 update. I have gone through and pretty much cleaned up everything. I got a few more things to put away, but it's going to be a real fast pack up and go tomorrow morning. It'll just be my sleeping bag, my hammock, and my chair. You know, I could wake up in the morning, sit down in my chair, enjoy the monster coffee, catch my wits about me, and then just quickly throw everything in the car and get on the road. I want to be on the road by about 7:30, like I said earlier, at the latest. And that way I'm not fighting traffic, and I'm also not going to be unpacking the car in the mid-90s that it's supposed to be again tomorrow. So, I wasn't going to have a fire tonight, but while I was running to town really quick, Matt decided to drop off a pile of firewood for me, so not going to be burning all of this tonight, but I will be having a little bit of a fire. That way it'll get rid of any last remnants of garbage in the fire pit that might be there. Paper, maybe part of an aluminum can or something. I don't know. But the heat has dropped. It is down to, looks like 87 degrees. Just looking on my other phone really quick. I should say my phone. I'm talking to my camera right now. Yep, it is down to 84 right now. So the heat is done. It is going to keep dropping another hour. It'll be into the 70s. But this will be my last video of the night. This is the very end of the daylight. Thanks for sticking around. Well, that wraps up another fun weekend out in the woods. I'm recording this last segment at home because I left 44 North at 4:45, 5 o'clock this morning. The heat did break eventually last night, did get down into the low 70s, but the humidity rolled in, so it was 71 degrees with like 78% humidity. So everything was sticky. It just wasn't really comfortable to sleep in, and I already had 3 days of ick all over me, and then there was just more ick. And so I slept for about 4 hours or so. I think I finally fell asleep about midnight. And I woke up at 4, and there was no going back to sleep. My alarm was already set for 6:30. So it's like, oh, I could lay here and toss and turn for 2.5 hours, or I can just hurry up and pack up by my headlamp, because I had almost everything packed up already. And I could hit the road and beat all that traffic. And I tell you, I beat the traffic. I was the only car on the road the first 100 miles. So, some lessons were learned this trip. I don't have the power bank capacity for 4 days. That really ran out on the final day. Had to plug in one power bank in the car while I ran my errands yesterday. just to give that one a little bit of juice to squeeze me through the night. So another 4-day trip, I'm going to have to look into a couple more power banks or maybe another big Anker power bank like I have. But I think a couple smaller ones would be better than the big one, just for speakers or little things that don't need a big power bank to do those types of things. Another thing that I've finally reached the breaking point on that I've known for a while is I've got to go through and reorganize my gear. There's so much stuff in there I don't use. There's so much stuff in there I can't find because it's under the stuff I don't use, or I hastily and or drunkenly put it away and I just can't find it, but it's in there somewhere. Who knows? So that'll be next weekend's to-do list, is just bring all my camping gear out of the car, bring it up here, open it all up, dump it all out, reorganize it, really seriously reconsider the things I need and don't need on certain trips. But other than that, it was a great time. 4 days is a bit long to go without a shower, so I think my next 4-day trip I might hit up the truck stop or something. The first 3 days were nice, but the hot day, that really sent it over the edge. But I mean, going forward, lessons have been learned and adjustments know they need to be made. I want to do a 4-day trip. I've had the 4-day trip planned. I did the 4-day trip. And now I know what I need to do to make my next 4-day trip more successful. Anyway, thanks for watching. We're going to go ahead and start the editing process on this now and hopefully get it uploaded by the end of the night. We'll see you next time.